Hello, my name is Siavash Irani, a solutions architect here at AWS, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can troubleshoot your Amazon EC2 Windows instances using EC2 Serial Console. Why using EC2 Serial Console? This is useful when you don't have any network connectivity to your instance, or when Windows is failing to boot into normal mode and other ways of connecting to your instance like remote desktop protocol does not work. To set up Serial Console, we need to grant access to the Serial Console at the account level. At the OS level, we need to make sure Windows BCD or boot configuration have the boot menu and EMS or emergency management services enabled. And currently it's only supported on instance types that are running based on AWS Nitro system. And it's not supported on Xen-based instance types or EC2 bare metal. Just a few additional information. Please be aware that by default, BCD configuration does not have boot menu and EMS or special admin console, also known as SAC, enabled on EC2 Windows instances. This is because EC2 launch agents use serial port to generate password and console log output. Another important thing to note is, when your instance is already failing health check and you're trying to enable its BCD configuration for serial console access, you have to detach its root volume and attach it to another instance, also known as helper instance, as secondary volume. If your secondary instance or helper instance has the same operating system as your original instance, there is a chance that this signature of the volumes for both your helper and the problematic OS are the same. And in this case, what happens, Windows modifies the disk signature of your unreachable instance. And when you attach that volume back to your original unreachable instance and you're trying to boot off of it, it will fail to boot because the signature has been changed. So it's very important to use a different Windows edition for your helper instance. You can also use AWS support enable Windows EC2 Serial Console Automation Runbook to enable BCD configuration for serial access for both online and offline instances at scale. With that, let's get to our demo section. For the demo, I've created this demo instance which is failing health checks and it's unreachable. To connect over Serial Console, first we need to come under EC2 settings and go to EC2 Serial Console and hit and manage and enable EC2 Serial Console access. But this is still not enough because we have to go to the operating system and at the OS level, we need to enable the BCD configuration. Since this instance is already unreachable, I have to stop the instance and then detach its root volume and attach it to a helper instance which I've created using a different operating system in the same availability zone as my original instance so I can attach its volume as secondary volume to that instance. Now that the instance is stopped, I'm going to click on storage and select its root volume, detach that root volume, once the volume's in available state, I'm going to attach it to my helper instance. So hit attach and select the helper instance. I leave the mount name as XPDF in this case. Hit attach. And then I need to RDP to my helper instance. So I've already RDP'd to that instance. If I open disk management, this D drive is basically the root volume of my unreachable instance, which I want to edit its BCD configuration. To do so, I'm going to open command prompt. And from here, I'm going to run my first command, which basically just queries what is inside my BCD configuration. Notice here that EMS is set to no. I'm going to run a few commands to enable the Serial Console now. So the first one is this one, which it sets the EMS and turns it on. Second one, it's going to set the settings for the EMS and the serial port rates. And next one will enable the boot menu. And after that, I'm going to set the boot timeout to 15. This will allow me enough time to interact with the serial console before Windows defaults to boot in normal mode. And of course, the last command, it's gonna set it so it boots with EMS. Notice that in all of these commands, I'm using /store flag to target that secondary volume BCD configuration. And if I was trying to modify the BCD store on the currently running instance, this flag was not needed. Now all of my instance BCD configuration is set, and I just have to detach its volume and bring it back. So I'm going to take the volume offline from disk management, and then from the volumes under EC2, select that volume and detach it from my temporary instance. Once detached, I'm going to select that volume and attach it to my original instance. So select demo instance. I need to select the root volume mount point, hit attach volume. And after that, I'm going to come back to the instances and start my demo instance. Once the instance is in running state, I'm going to click on connect. And then from here, select EC2 Serial Console and hit connect. You can see it opens a new tab with a serial console connection here. I'm going to do a quick reboot on my instance so we can see the boot menu here. So if I come back here after doing the reboot, here if I press escape and 8, then it gives me the menu to select safe mode or safe mode with networking or command prompt. And in this case, I'm going to hit escape and left arrow so I come back to the original Windows EMS mode, and in this case I'm going to click on EMS and boot into EMS. In here you can see it prompts with the SAC or special admin console. I'm going to type in help to get me to a list of commands where I can run here. I'm going to run cmd and from here do a ch-l, which basically lists all the channels that I've opened here. Then I use ch-si and number 1 to connect to the channel 1, which is in this case is my CMD. And in here, it's going to ask for my credentials of my instance. Let me enter the credentials real quick. Now you can see I have full command prompt here. I could also run PowerShell here, but in this case I'm going to just run a few NetSH commands because for this particular demo I've disabled the primary NIC for my instance. So I'm going to just get a list of network interfaces for my instance. You can see that it is disabled, so I'm going to enable this real quick. You can see that the NIC now enabled and it's connected. If I come back to the instance and hit refresh, now the instance should start passing health checks. Please don't forget to revert the BCD settings if you no longer need or want the EMS enabled on your instance. With that, we get to the end of our demo section. I hope you found this informative, and thanks for watching.